Hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. I am your mentor Manish Mishra and in this session we'll discuss 5 more MCQs from the PIB news. I hope guys your preparations are going well. In this golden period of lockdown, just keep on revising all the notes and just keep on completing all the syllabus jo bhi aapka bacha hua hai. Alright, so let's begin with the session. As on March 2020, approximately how many MSMEs have been registered on Udyog Aadhaar portal since 1st April 2017. So this Udyog Aadhaar scheme was launched in 2015 by Ministry of MSME under MSME Development Act, MSME Development Act of 2006. So this was launched in 2015 under MSME Development Act of 2006. Udyog Aadhaar is basically a 12-digit unique identification number given to all MSME registered owners and it is also known as Aadhaar for Business. Okay, it is also known as Aadhaar for Business and the registration in Udyog Aadhaar portal is absolutely free for all the MSME business owners and government has also set up an Udyog Aadhaar portal which is udyogaadhaar.gov.in for online filing of Udyog Aadhaar memorandum. Now as of March 2020 the number of MSME registered on Udyog Aadhaar portal since 1st April 2017 are 61.06 lakh and the maximum numbers are in Maharashtra and minimum are in Ladakh. So therefore the answer to this question must be what was the question? How many approximately MSMEs have been registered on Udyog Aadhaar portal? So approximately it is 61 lakh. Now what is the benefit of registering oneself in Udyog Aadhaar? So there are so many benefits like there is fast resolution of disputes, payment disputes ka fast resolution hoga isme register hone ke baad. Next is collateral free loan mil sakta hai from the banks, right? Collateral free loan from the banks, 15% subsidy mil sakti hai under 15% subsidy under credit linked capital subsidy scheme and also protection against delayed payments. Okay, protection against delayed payments bhi jo MSME owners hai unko milega jab wo Udyog Aadhaar mein apne aap ko register kara lenge. So there are so many benefits like fast resolution of disputes, collateral free loan from the bank, 15% subsidy under credit linked capital subsidy scheme and protection against delayed payments. Alright, so it is a quite beneficial scheme for all the MSME owners and till from 1st April 2017 till March 2020, 61 lakh MSME are already registered under Udyog Aadhaar portal. This was launched in 2015 under MSME Development Act of 2006. Now next question is, exports from the small scale sector over a period of time have acquired great significance in India's foreign trade. The share of exports of specified MSME related products in all India exports each of the last 3 years and current year 2020 is around what? So agar hum is table pe dhyan de, is data pe dhyan de, in 2016-17 the share of export of MSME related products in the all India export was 49.69%. In 2017-18 it is 48.56%. In 2018-19 it is 48.10% and in 2019-20 up to December 2019 it is 49.81%. So we can say that the share of MSME related products in all India exports is between 47 to 50%. Okay, 47 se leke 50% ka jo share hai wo all India exports mein kiska hai? MSME related products ka hai. And the government is working with an aim to rise MSME share in exports up to 60%. जो MSME का share है वो government 60% तक लेके आना चाहती है and 2018 में government ने $100 billion export from the MSME का target भी set किया था by 2020 तक. Alright, and minister of MSME is Nitin Gadkari whose Lok Sabha constituency is Nagpur, the city of oranges. Now the next question is, the Ministry of MSME has launched the Mission Solar Charkha in 2018-19 for implementation of 50 Solar Charkha clusters across the country. Till date, March 2020, how many projects have been approved under the mission? So this Mission Solar Charkha, there was a pilot project under this mission which was launched in 2016. in Khanwa village of Nawada district of Bihar. Okay, so इसका pilot project Khanwa village Nawada district में launch हुआ था 2016 में, and after the success of this pilot project, government of India has launched this mission solar charkha in 2018-19 for implementation of 50 solar charkha clusters. Under this scheme, under this mission, an employment to 1 lakh people will be provided in these 50 clusters. In 50 clusters में 1 लाख लोगों को employment provide कराने का provision है इस mission में, और ये जो 50 clusters होंगे उसमें से जो 10% हैं वो नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न रीजन में होने चाहिए, जम्मू कश्मीर में होने चाहिए और हिली एरियाज में होने चाहिए. आउट ऑफ द 50 क्लस्टर्स 10% शुड बी इन नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न रीजन, जम्मू एंड कश्मीर एंड हिली एरियाज. ओके, एंड वन क्लस्टर ऑफ सोलर चरखा वुड इन्वॉल्व मैक्सिमम सब्सिडी ऑफ रुपीज 9.599 करोड़ एंड अ टोटल ऑफ 550 करोड़ इज प्रोवाइडेड टू दिस mission. Until date, only 10 projects have been approved under this mission and one solar charkha has been identified in Andhra Pradesh. Alright, so the answer to this question is how many projects have been approved under the mission? So only 10 projects have been approved under the mission solar charkha. Next question is, India is a signatory to the World Health Organization resolution on Vision 2020, the right to sight. National Program for Control of Blindness and Visual Impairment NPCV and VI is working towards to fulfill India's resolution. What are the total number of functional eye banks including eye donation centers in India under the National Program for Control of Blindness and Visual Impairment by March 2020? Okay, so India is a signatory to resolution on Vision 2020, the right to sight, which was launched in 1999 for prevention of blindness. Okay, blindness ko dur karne ke liye, prevention of blindness. Alright, so to prevent the blindness, this Vision 2020, the right to sight, was launched in 1999 and it is a joint initiative of WHO and International Agency for the Prevention of Blindness. Okay. It is a joint initiative of WHO and International Agency for Prevention of Blindness. And the World Sight Day every year is observed on 2nd Thursday of October. Alright guys, 2nd Thursday of October ko World Sight Day observe kiya jata hai puri duniya mein. And this NPCV and VI, this was launched in 1976 as a 100% centrally sponsored scheme, which is now 60:40 in all the states and 90:10 in northeastern state. And this was launched by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. This program was launched to reduce the prevalence of blindness to 0.3% by 2020. And this aims to provide eye health for all and prevention of visual impairment through the provision of comprehensive universal eye care services and quality service delivery to all. And under this program, the total number of functional eye banks including eye donation centers in India are 380 till March 2020. So the correct answer to this question is 380. And let me tell you one thing here, that in 2019, WHO has released its World Vision Report, and according to this report, 2.2 billion people have some form of visual impairment across the world. 2.2 billion people ko kisi na kisi form ka visual impairment hai puri duniya mein. And isme ek word hai, avoidable blindness, uski kafi charcha rehti hai. What is this avoidable blindness? So avoidable blindness is So it is defined as that blindness which could be either treated or prevented by known and cost effective means. ये avoidable blindness क्या है? ये वो blindness है जिसको सही किया जा सकता है या prevent करा जा सकता है किसी ऐसे means से जो कि cost effective हो और जाना हुआ हो. Okay, so it is defined as blindness which could be either treated or prevented by known and cost effective means. So I hope this avoidable blindness is clear now, and the answer to this question is 380. This Vision 2020, the Right to Sight, was launched in 1999 for prevention of blindness. It is a joint initiative of International Agency for the Prevention of Blindness and WHO. WHO chief is Tedros Adhanom from Ethiopia. World Sight Day every year is observed on 2nd Thursday of October, and in 2019, WHO has released its World Vision Report, according to which 2.2 billion people are suffering from some form of visual impairment across the world. And National Program for Control in Blindness and Visual Impairment was launched in 1976 with an aim to reduce the prevalence of blindness to 0.3% by 2020. Okay, so I hope this question is clear now. Now next question is, Ministry of HRD launched a portal in March 2020 developed by UGC, University Grant Commission, that aims towards empowerment of women in campuses through creating awareness. What is that portal? So let us discuss about this portal. It is developed by UGC, which aims towards empowerment of women in campuses through creating awareness on three things. What are these three things? Existing opportunities and initiatives, support and redressal mechanism. So teen cheezon ke liye women ko aware karne ke liye aur unko empower karne ke liye in campuses this portal, section portal, was launched by UGC. Okay, and what are these three things? One is existing opportunities and initiative, next support, and next is redressal mechanism. Okay, and Minister of HRD is Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank from Haridwar. Unki Lok Sabha constituency hai Haridwar. Now there is one URL address, which is saksham.ugc.ac.in, and an email address gssec.ugc@nic.in, and an upload your complaint option is also provided under grievance redressal on the portal. So the correct answer to this question is, what is that portal? So the portal is Saksham portal. Let me repeat this explanation. This portal aims towards empowerment of women in campuses through creating awareness on the existing opportunities and initiatives, support and redressal mechanism. And this has been launched by Ministry of HRD and developed by University Grants Commission. आपको इसका जो aim है वो याद रखना है, and इसको किसने develop किया वो याद रखना है, and इसको किसने launch किया वो भी याद रखना है. Alright, so that's it for today's session. I hope you like the session. For more updates, do subscribe our channel anujjindal.in and press the bell icon. मिलते हैं next session में. Goodbye, take care, God bless, and keep watching PIB 24/7.